I've been, you know, playing rock music since a very young age, but at the same time I've always taken a keen interest in learning about music and its history and the theory behind how it's composed and how it's written and how it's put together. So, but for so long I think that, you know, my interest in classical and orchestral music and rock music has always been segregated. With the project that I'm involved in right now with the HPO, it's kind of finally like this epiphany moment for me where, you know, I really get to merge both passions together for, I think, the first time. I mean, there's been little bits and pieces of it over the years where there's been some intersection, but this is the first time in a big way where both are seem to be converging.
When I see a guy like Brent, I see someone like me that doesn't really have boundaries. You know, he tends to stay in the rock area and I tend to stay in the classical area, but we both are comfortable in working in the other space, and I don't think either of us feel like we're this one thing. I like to think that, you know, all music is enjoyable, and I don't really like to define myself by any one genre, so I don't really separate them that much.
I don't put any restrictions on myself as to what kind of music I should be playing or what kind of music I should be writing. I mean, whatever strikes me as inspiring in that moment is kind of what I pursue, and so again, this project is a really a great way to be pursuing that, and really excited about for that reason.
The people that I've worked with on this project, the other classical players, have all been very excited to do this. It's something a little bit outside the usual, and the way we're working together, it's a much smaller group, it's much more intimate, so the players feel much more like they're contributing on the same level as the band.
I think that the key though is to try to be doing something interesting, and that's where a project like this is I think really important, is that, you know, it's not something that an audience is used to seeing. I mean, and the fact that we get to do it at the Supercrawl, which really has an audience in place, you know, regardless of whether we're there or not, serves as a really good medium for that, for this kind of project, to expose people that, you know, may not even be seeking it, to you know, a brand new take, I think, on what, you know, music can be about. And
what the big difference now with younger string players is we've all grown up with rock and roll. Rock and roll is now 60 years old, so almost every young player I know has some interest and at least a good deal of knowledge of what rock music is about, and they seem a lot more open to playing it, and it's not seen as something that they're doing because, you know, they have to.
And that's where I think people have this misconception, like, you know, orchestral music and rock music are worlds apart. I mean, we're using the same parameters. Melody, harmony, rhythm. I mean, music is very fundamental, and that's why I think all music can really resonate with us if we are open enough to allow it to do so. There really aren't any boundaries with music. There's no, you know, specific demographic that we're trying to appeal to. I mean, it's really about getting as many people, as many different people from different backgrounds and different age groups and different experiences and different cultures together to enjoy, you know, the simplicity and beauty that is music, and music being shared and performed by human beings on a stage together.
One of the arrangements I've been working on is Beedlow from Pictures at an Exhibition, and it's kind of a dark, heavy piece of music, and I think it'll work well for our ensemble because we have a lot of low instruments. We have the double bass, electric bass, and cello, and even the guitars are fairly low in register, and in that piece there's a lot of low writing, and I think that will translate really well into this little, it's not a long piece, but it's a cool little thing, and I think the audience will enjoy it quite a bit. These type of collaborations don't happen often in the orchestral world, largely because we show up at work and are handed a bunch of music that's arranged by someone else. In this case, all the performers involved have a hand in working on the music, coming up with the music, and creating it completely on our own. So it's a very unique experience in terms of this kind of performance. And working with Thought Beneath Film has been a real pleasure
for me. My band Thought Beneath Film is extremely excited to be involved with the HPO in this project, and to be able to do something that I think will really promote inclusivity and unity within the various music traditions happening within the Hamilton community.